Let's first start with a quarter circle and then let's construct the half circle so that it touches the quarter circle at the single point. Also, the centers of our quarter circle and our half circle are located at the same horizontal line. Now, let's pull a line from the upper left corner of our quarter circle to the down right corner of our half circle. This line will have multiple intersections with our previously constructed shapes. So we can say that the length of the segment inside the half circle is equal to 4, and the length of the segment between the half circle and the quarter circle is equal to 3. Now we will pull the line from the center of the quarter circle that is perpendicular to our previously constructed line, and we will notice this red right triangle. The question is, can you calculate the area of this red right triangle? I will now encourage you to pause the video and try to solve this awesome geometry problem for yourself, and then come back to check the result. Alright, so let's solve this one. So first, let's mark the center of our quarter circle as O, and then let's mark all the intersection points of our line as A, B, C, and D. We will also mark the remaining vertices of our right triangle as Q, and the connection point between our quarter circle and our half circle as P. Now, let's notice the line OD. It represents the radius of our quarter circle and we will label it as R. You can also notice that the line OP is also equal to R. Now let's pull a line from the point C to the point P, and we will try to calculate the angle at the point C. But first, we will notice that the inner angle at the point O is equal to 90 degrees, since we have a quarter circle. That means that the outer angle at the point O must be 270 degrees. Now let's clear our image a little bit and only leave the lines inside the quarter circle. Now we will use the inscribed angle theorem to find the angle at the point C. Just to remind you, the inscribed angle theorem states that an inscribed angle on a circle is always the half measure of the central angle that subtends. Since in our case we have the outer angle, our sketch will look something like this. Now we will label all the vertices on our right sketch the same way as the vertices on our left sketch. And we can easily see that the central angle of 2 theta corresponds to the angle of 270 degrees. That means that the angle at the point C must be the half of the value of the 270 degrees, and that is 135 degrees. So, with this in mind, we will go back to our original sketch. Now we can conclude that the angle of 135 degrees and the acute angle at the point C are supplementary angles. That means that the acute angle at the point C must be equal to 45 degrees. Now let's pull a line from the point P to the point B, and let's also set our attention to the line AB. Now we will mark the center of our half circle as S, and we can clear our image a little bit. Now we can notice that the angle at the point S is 180 degree angle. So we can again use our inscribed angle theory. And if we label all the points on the sketch on the right the same way as on the sketch on the left, you can clearly see that the angle of 180 degrees corresponds to the central angle. That means that the angle at the point B must be the half of the value of the 180 degrees, so that angle is the 90 degree angle. Now let's head back to our original sketch again. And we can notice that the angle at the point B on the other side is also 90 degree angle. Now we will set our attention to this blue triangle PCB. Since this triangle has the angles of 90 degrees and 45 degrees, that means that the remaining acute angle of this triangle must be equal to 45 degrees. So we can conclude that this triangle must be isosceles right triangle. And how awesome is that? Because we now know that the line CB is congruent to the line PB. And that means that the length of the line PB is also equal to 3. Now, let's set our attention to the right triangle PBA. This is a classical 3-4-5 right triangle, so we know that hypotenuse PA of this triangle must have the value of 5. If you're a newcomer to mathematics, you can pause the video and check how I got the value of PA using the Pythagorean theorem. Alright, so now let's set our attention to this purple right triangle OAD. This triangle has the height of R and the base of R plus 5. And let's notice the acute angle at the point A of this triangle. If we go back to our previous right triangle PAB, you can notice that this triangle shares the same angle at the point A with our purple triangle. Since both the purple and the green triangle are right triangles, that means that their remaining angles are congruent. With that in mind, we can conclude that the triangle ODA must be similar to the triangle BPA. Now we will isolate those triangles. First, we will isolate our purple triangle with the base of R plus 5 and the height of R. And then we can isolate and rotate our green triangle so it corresponds with our purple triangle. This green triangle will have the base of 4 and the height of 3. Now we can use the rule of similarity that states that the relation between the sides of these two triangles must be equal. So we can substitute our values and get that R plus 5 over R must be equal to 4 over 3. Now we can cross multiply our values and get the following. Here we can simplify and we will put the unknowns on the left side of the equation and finally get that the radius of our quarter circle is equal to 15. Alright, so now let's go back to our purple right triangle once again. We can now use the Pythagorean theorem for this one. We can say that the hypotenuse DA squared is equal to the leg OD squared plus the leg OA squared. Now we will substitute our values from the sketch. You can see that the length of hypotenuse DA is equal to the sum of the segments DC, 3 and 4. Leg OD is of course equal to 15. And the leg OA is equal to the sum of the segments with the values 15 and 5. Now we can simplify this and we can square the values on the right. And we will get that the quantity of DC plus 7 squared is equal to 625. Of course, after simplifying, we will get the following. And that means that the segment DC is equal to 25 minus 7, which means that our segment DC must be equal to 18. Now, let's head back to our original sketch. Once more, we will set our attention to the radius OD. If we rotate this radius to the point C, you can notice that the line OC must also have the value of 15. So that means that the triangle OCD must be an isosceles triangle with the base of 18 and the height OQ, which we will label as H. Since we know that the height of the isosceles triangle divides its base into two identical segments, we can conclude that the segment DQ must have the value of 9. Now let's go back to our red right triangle. Now we can find the value of the height H by using the Pythagorean theorem. We can say that h squared must be equal to 15 squared minus 9 squared, so we can simplify this and get that h squared is equal to 144. Of course, after doing the square root, we can conclude that the height of our red triangle is equal to 12. Now it's easy for us to find the area of this red right triangle, since the area of the right triangle is equal to the half of the product of its legs, so in our case that is dq times oq over 2. We will substitute our values and we will get that that is 108 over 2, which means that the area of our red right triangle must be equal to 54 squared units, and this is our solution. I hope you guys found your way of solving this awesome geometry problem, and if you enjoyed this video, give it a like and consider subscribing to the channel if you already haven't. Of course, until next time, see you guys and take care.